Hi! Like you are probably noticing that I'm not Yuban Mastery. My name is Omega Chaos, and my Yu-Gi-Oh! Duelist and Yu-Gi-Tuber from Estonia. Yuban Mastery was nice enough to allow me to post on his channel. So the deck I'm going to show you is my Rank Up Shark deck. It's a deck I have been working on for a really long time now. And it's one of my favorite decks of all time. So, let's go to this deck. First, the monsters. One Depth Shark, pretty decent level 5 shark. I can normal summon this without tributing if I have no monsters on the field, on my field. And once the opponent's turn phase, this card's attack is doubled until the end phase. So it's basically a 2800 attack beater on the opponent's turn. So, pretty nice I think. Then, free double Fin Shark, one of the most important cards in this deck. When this card is normal summoned, I can basically play someone a level 3 or level 4 water fish type monster from my graveyard in face of defense, and its effects are negated. But I can't spell summon any other monsters other than water monsters during the turn if I activate this effect. So it's basically one card rank for a water XE summon in this deck, which is really good. And basically in this deck all the X deck is water, so it's not really a restriction. Aside from Kersky XX Sparian of course. Then, free Shaper Shark, which is basically like a Constella Chaos of the deck. I can increase a level of fish type monsters 2 times. So, but it has the same restriction as a double Fin Shark, that I can only plus one water monsters that turn. So, definitely really good card to summon out your rank 5. Water Axis monsters. Then, free Wind Up Shark. It's a really good card in here actually. It's a level 4 fish that can modify its levels. And it's actually now even better thanks to a beautiful princess. So, yeah. Then, 2 Mermaid Shark. When this is a normal summon, I can search out a level 3, level 4, or level 5. Fish type monster from my deck to my hand. So it's basically like a Stratos of the deck, but I only run 2 because it's just so weak. And you don't really want to draw like too many of this card. Then, 3 Sun Angler. If you control a water monster, I can personal this card from my hand, but I can't personal any other monster from my hand that turn. So definitely really good for your Xyz plays. Then 2 Xyz Remora, it's one of the power cards in the deck. I can pass one discard from hand by detaching 2 materials from my monsters I control. And if I do, I can pass one 2 level 4 beast of monster from a graveyard in face of defense, but their effects are negated. I can only, they can't attack or change the battle positions, and they can only be used as Xyz materials for a water Xyz monster. So definitely one of the main ways to summon out your number 32 Shark Drake. Then 1 Shocktopus, a pretty decent level 4 fish. When this card destroys a battle, I can equip it to the opponent monster that destroyed this, and that monster attack becomes 0. So, pretty good. Then 2 Beautiful Princess. This card's name is pretty hard to pronounce if it's a new TCG name. Basically, when this card's a normal special one, I can banish this card. And then you press one level 4 or lower fish that monster from the deck, except this card. So, a pretty good card. It's like a long fire blossom for fish that monsters, but it's of course not as good. So, it works well with Wind Up Shark as well. So, now the spells. Of course, since a rank up shark deck, I use the rank up magic quick chaos. It's a quick play, a rank of magic, really good, but it's also the most restrictive because I can only rank up the same number as I'm going to rank up into. Then two language variants force. Mostly I prefer either limited variants force for rank 4 base text and rank magic the Ocean Chaos force for higher rank decks. But in this deck I use both rank 5s and rank 4s and I have and Abyss Supra and Chaos Number 101. So I have to use this because there is no other option available. Other than maybe Numenor Force, but that isn't that great. I can also use this on my Crystal Zero Lancer to rank up into Kowski's Baryon if I want to. Then, one generation of Force. If I control Xyz Monster, I can search out an Xyz card from my deck to my hand. So I can search out either Xyz Remora or Xyz Reflect. So definitely not bad. Then two Salvage. It must recycle many of my monsters in this deck, because most of my monsters in this deck are 1500 or less. So definitely really good. Then two Forbidden Lands, of course, protect my monsters from spells and traps. Then two Mesca Space Typhoon for bug removal, of course. And one Dark Hole for a last spell. No traps. Plus two Xyz Reflect. I think it's one of the most underrated cards currently. Basically, its effect is when a spell or trap or effect monster effect is activated that targets the face of Xyz monsters or monsters on the field, negate activation and destroy it, then inflict 800 damage to a point. So definitely not bad. Especially that Chaos Number 101 and Chaos Number 73 have destruction immunity. Chaos Number 73 covers destroyable card effects if it has number 73 as a Xyz material, and Chaos Number 101 comes back if I have a regular 101 in the graveyard and it still has Xyz material. So yeah, definitely helps to protect your monsters from things like Dimensional Prison and Phoenix Wingwind Blast if people still play it. Then two Fish Step Charge. Basically like a Gemini Spark of the deck, tribute one Fish Step monster, then destroy one card on the field, and then I can draw one card. The Nara Traps, Solemn Warning. Of course, you know, I consider this to be the most spoken trap card in the game. Bottom Trap Hole. One Black Horn of Heaven. It's really good in this current game. And two Fence Chain, of course, really good, although it's not as great as it was before, with artifacts being a thing. Then Exodec. First, Chaotic Xyz Baryon. Basically, I summon this card by overlaying over the your Chaos Number 101 most of the time. I just use this as finisher. It gains 1000 attack for each Xyz material on it. And it can also copy a number of monsters effect from the graveyard. So definitely not bad, but I'm not going to summon it that often. Then, Chaos Number 23, Abyss Supra Splash. It's a really powerful Chaos number. Its first effect is like Honest effect. And if this card has number 23 Abyss Plus, like Xyz material, this card cannot be destroyed by card effect. So definitely really powerful and really good. Then of course the main Chaos number in the deck, Chaos Number 101, Southward Dark. I can of course target one special monster of one controls, attach to this card as base of Xyz material. And when this card is destroyed, I send it to the graveyard, while it has Xyz material, I imprison this card from a graveyard, then gain a life point equal to the original attack of this card. But of course regular 101 has to be in the graveyard to activate this effect. And if this card special summon that way, I can't attack that turn. Then, Full Now Crystal Zero Lancer. Basically like a big monster, given Xyz one by overlaying over your rank 5 water monsters. And of course, by detaching, I can negate the effects of 4 phase of monsters one currently controls at the end of this turn. So definitely really powerful. Then, and number 73 Abyss Plus. It can double its attack, but battle damage opponent takes his halt for the rest of the turn. So definitely not bad. Then, number 94, Crystal Zero, it's basically like opposite of number 73, it's Shrink on Legs. Then, number 101, Sato Arc. Don't think I have to explain this card. It's Moth Pest, rank 4 in the game, of course. And can get rid of many problematic cards. And especially good in this deck because you can pretty much summon it by with only one card. Then, number 32 Shock Trick. A really powerful card. It has one of the most unique effects, I think. Basically, when this attacking card destroys a opponent's monster battle, and sends it to the graveyard, and it detaches one excision material, and then I can place one that destroys monsters to one side in the face of attack region, and it loses 1000 attack, and then I can attack it again, so I can inflict huge damage. This effect. Then, two Power Monster Shark. I can detach one excision material, plus one on one rank 3 or lower world excision monster from my X deck, but that this card can attack. Rest of turn if I had used this effect. Definitely really good to sum out your rank freeze in the deck and then overlay to full mount Black Ray Lancer, which is a really good card in here. It has self protection that if this face up card on the field will destroy it, I can attach all of its excision materials instead. And when this card is off once more at battle, I can destroy one spell that trap with one controls. Then, your rank 3, so I'm going to summon out with Bahamut Shark. And number 17, Left Hand Dragon, just to do attack Peter, but it can't attack directly because it has no excess materials. And for Submersible Carrier Aura Shark, I use this because it's a fish type monster, which means I can use it for fish depth charge. So it's definitely really good in that. So this was my Rank of Shark deck profile. If you liked this video, I suggest you check out my channel. I do a lot of unique deck profiles, and I also have free to annexes I do each week. One of them focuses on different prophecy decks, and the other one focuses on different rank of base decks, and third one focuses on just other decks that are not prophecy or rank up based. So, and I also do some card discussions as well. So, I hope you enjoyed this deck profile. Goodbye and Omega Chaos out!